Are discounts and shopping festivals burning a hole in your pocket? Do you regret overspending but unable to get rid of your habit? Hi, I'm Apurva from ClearTax. Here, I have a solution for your habit of overspending and impulsive buying, that is the 30-day rule. Wondering what it is and how it can help you? Well, here is the answer. The 30-day rule is a mindset you must practice to get rid of impulsive buying. It is not even tough, but requires determination from your end. Here are the steps you need to follow. Step 1. Whenever you feel the urge to buy a non-essential item, either at a retail store or online store, tell yourself to stop. Leave the retail store or close the app or site immediately. Step 2. Write down the following: date of the event, the thing you wanted to buy, where you can buy it, the price of the item, the date after 30 days from the date of the event. Meaning, you have to delay the purchase of the non-essential item for 30 days. Step 3. During the 30-day waiting period, your mind will still dwell on the purchase you have delayed. Meanwhile, you will also retrospect if it was a want or a need to buy the item and if it was worth spending your discretionary funds on it. Step 4. After 30 days, if you still wish to buy the item, then you can buy it as it is not impulsive buying anymore. The cause of overspending. Fear of missing out, FOMO. FOMO spending refers to a form of anxiety that makes you think that if you don't purchase a particular item right then, you will miss out on something big. This is mostly induced by social media, where people in your circle keep posting on their new purchases and check-ins, in turn pushing you into an invisible competition with them. The fear of falling behind in the race will lead you to spending money as a motivation irrespective of your affordability. Does delayed gratification help? Delayed gratification is the practice of delaying the act of appreciating yourself until the appropriate time. You can apply this concept to matters related to finances. Though it is not easy to delay something that can make you happy, stay informed that delayed gratification can lead to bigger rewards. For example, you open an RD account for 6 months where you put in all that money you will be receiving as a hike in your salary. You promise to reward yourself with that rosewood cupboard on maturity of the 6-month RD if you perform well at your job and succeed to secure a 5 rating, even though you can afford to buy the cupboard right now. Since a rosewood cupboard is not a need and only a want, delay this gratification for some time. Over the next 6 months, you will stay determined at work and give your 100% to secure a 5 rating. Also, you may get the cupboard in bigger dimension with better design at the end of the 6-month period, all at the same price as compared to the present day. A small addition to the 30-day rule. To make the 30-day rule more diligent, you can add the amount equivalent to the cost of the item you wish to purchase in the bank account that you use for saving. As you watch the money earn interest and grow over the 30-day period, you may become less tempted towards buying that item and would want the money to stay there so you can use it at a later time for a bigger purpose. Practicing this rule will make you less vulnerable to discounts, shopping festivals, and other colorful ad campaigns eventually. So, what do you think about the 30-day rule? Wanna give it a try?